have both magnitude and direction. So two vectors cannot be added by the method of ordinary algebra. So for adding two vectors, there are different methods. Triangle law of addition. Now, two vectors are there, A and B. This is the tail of A, this is the head of A. Similarly, tail of B, tail of head. To add these two vectors, draw A as it is. Then, without rotating, move B such that tail of B touches the head of A. Now, join tail of A and head of B. So that is the resultant of A vector and B vector. If two vectors are represented by two sides of a triangle taken in order, then the third side will give you the resultant. Now, OQ vector is equal to OP vector plus PQ vector. Then magnitude of the resultant. For getting the magnitude of the resultant, extend this side. Then from Q, you drop a perpendicular. Then angle between A vector and B vector. This is A vector. This is the direction of A vector. This is the direction of B vector. Angle between them is theta. Resultant is making an angle alpha with the direction of A vector. Now take this triangle. In this triangle, cos theta is Pn by B, where B is the modulus of B vector. So Pn is equal to B cos theta. Similarly, sin theta. Sin theta is opposite side by hypotenuse. Opposite side is Qn. Hypotenuse is B, modulus of B vector. This is B vector. So this length of this side is B. Now, Qn is B sin theta. Now you take this triangle, OQn. In triangle OQn, you apply Pythagoras theorem. So OQ square is equal to On square plus Qn square. On can be written as OP plus Pn. Now OQ. OQ is the magnitude of the resultant. This OQ vector is the R vector. So OQ is the length of this side, that is the magnitude of the resultant. So for OQ you can write R. So R square is equal to OP plus Pn all square plus Qn square. R square is equal to OP. This OP is the magnitude of A vector. So for OP you can write A plus Pn. Pn we can write B cos theta. It's all square plus Qn. Qn you can write B sin theta. It's a square. Now R square is equal to A square plus 2ab cos theta. A plus B all square. So 2ab cos theta plus for this B square cos square theta. When you square this plus B square sin square theta. In this B square is common, so you take B square outside. So it will be cos square theta plus sin square theta inside the bracket. Cos square theta plus sin square theta is 1. So R square is equal to A square plus 2ab cos theta plus B square. R square is equal to A square plus B square plus 2ab cos theta. If you take the square root, you will get the magnitude of the resultant. Magnitude of the resultant is equal to square root of A square plus B square plus 2ab cos theta. Then for resultant, there is a direction. So now let us see how to get the direction of resultant. Resultant is making an angle alpha with the direction of A vector. So if you can find alpha, we can get the direction of the resultant. So in this triangle, tan alpha is equal to Qn divided by On. Tan alpha is opposite side by adjacent side. Here opposite side is Qn, adjacent side is On. On can be written as OP plus PN. This Qn, Qn is B sine theta. This is, this length is B. Then this angle is theta. So opposite side is B sine theta. So for Qn, you can write B sine theta. OP is the magnitude of A vector. So A plus PN. PN is B cos theta. Now tan alpha is equal to B sine theta divided by A plus B cos theta. So alpha is equal to tan inverse B sine theta divided by A plus B cos theta. From this we can get alpha. So we can get the direction of the resultant. So thank you for watching.